What's up, makers? Mike Clifford here. Today, I'm gonna show you how I created this LED desk lamp. Now, I'm calling it the Living Art Desk Lamp because when you fire it up, it'll do all kinds of cool visualization patterns. It's also really practical as a normal desk lamp because you can switch the mode, so it just gives out a nice white light in a warm white or a cool white color of your choosing. It also has a red light as a nightlight setting. Hey everyone, real quick, I realized as I was about to start editing that I totally forgot one really important thing from my opening monologue there, and that was that I made three of these things. Two in bamboo plywood and one in walnut, which it's not seen here. The reason I made three of them is because I'm celebrating 50,000 subscribers with a giveaway. As soon as I figure out the logistics of organizing the giveaway, which should be sometime within the next week, I'll make an announcement here and on Instagram. So keep your eye out for that, and you can win one of these and some other cool prizes. But now let's get to the build. To construct the main miter box for the light, I used some scrap bamboo plywood and scrap walnut plywood that I had lying around. Since the scraps were different sizes, I used different techniques with the table saw to cut the pieces. And it looks a bit more complicated than it is, but at the end of the day, it's just four identical rectangles with 45 degree edges, and you can cut them any way you like with the table saw, circular saw, or miter saw. Since we're making this look more complicated than it is, figured why not have some fun and have some dramatic B-roll music to go along with it. Oh man, maybe I've been watching too many Peter McKinnon videos, but I have fun with that. Let me know what you think. Back to the build. The front of the light is made from a 1/8 inch sheet of acrylic, and your table saw blade is probably also 1/8 of an inch, so it pretty much works perfectly to cut a slot in the four sides of your box to hold the acrylic front. This part is optional, but I used a router to give the edges of the light a nice clean look. When making the first light, I routed what would be the front outer edges of the light first before the glue up, and I realized afterwards it was a mistake because the 45 degree miter corners got a lot of tear out when going through the router bit. Next, I used a rabbeting bit on all four sides of what would be the back of the lamp to cut out the rabbet for the back panel. This I do recommend doing before the glue up because it gives you square corners in your rabbet. While I'm cutting the acrylic sheets for the front of the lights, I just want to take a quick minute to remind you that if you like my videos, please click that subscribe button to get notified about future builds and click the like button below to let YouTube know you like it. It really does help me out and helps me keep going and making videos for you guys. For the glue up, I used the tape as a clamp technique, and there are a plethora of videos about this, so just search it if you need to figure it out. I won't go into detail here. The one thing I did do differently was to use the acrylic front panel and put it into the slots I cut in the four sides to hold them in place and make it easier to square up the box during the glue up. This worked really well. You just got to be careful not to get glue onto the acrylic panel. I cut the square back panels for the lights from 1/4 inch MDF using my new funky crosscut sled. Okay, so I gotta digress and talk about this funky crosscut sled because I didn't expect to like it as much as I did. Shop projects normally aren't my thing. So I wanna know if I can add some industrial twists to some shop projects. Would you like to see some video for those on my channel? Leave a comment and let me know. So here I'm just marking and drilling a 1/4 inch hole that will accept the power jack, and three 3/4 inch holes that will allow air to circulate and prevent overheating of the LEDs. Our glue up is now dried, so I removed all the tape from the box and went about drilling a hole to accept the LED push button. I used these same LED push buttons in my Bluetooth speaker build and inserted them into the wood in the same way. And it's a little bit tricky, so if you plan to make this, go back and watch that video to get the details on this process.
Don't know what I cut myself on, but one of you guys might have a little bit of actual blood, sweat, and tears going into your lamp.
Before moving on to the base, I want to back up and revisit the point about mistakenly routing the edges of the lamp before the glue up. For the second two, I routed the edges after the glue up and it worked much better. So we're in the middle of this project and ran into a design dilemma. My original plan was to use these steel flat irons and paint them white and then just attach those to this LED matrix so that we could rotate. And then I was just gonna use maybe some bamboo or the same kind of wood to attach this to the base, but I just didn't like how it looked. So back to the drawing board. Next idea was, well, maybe I'll make a statement and I'll put them on a live edge cookie slab. So I got these big slabs and I just tried how they looked on top of them and it wasn't working at all. We're getting even worse now. Finally, what I arrived on, which I think is gonna look pretty cool, was just to use a U-shaped base made out of the same material that we're making the box out of. You're going to take your 3/4 inch dowels, which have the 1/4 inch tapped hole drilled in them, insert them into the matching 3/4 inch hole, put those into the 3/4 inch holes and the sides of the lamp. And now you can kind of tilt this around, you can direct the light down, you can direct it up. Gotta do it. It's kind of like even like an old spotlight. We're gonna use brass thumb screws here on the side that are 1/4 inch, go into the threaded holes in the dowel, hold it together so you can lock it in place or unlock it to move it around. Without any further ado, let's get going. Let's put this base together and finish this light up. I'm ready to turn it on. Electronics for this are going to be dead simple. In fact, you can do it with no soldering. Yeah, I said that. No soldering. The only things I soldered were the Arduino Nano and a screw terminal that allows you to plug things easily in without soldering into the Nano. But you can buy both these products pre-soldered, and I'm going to put a link into the video description to all the things you need to do this without soldering. So you've got your LED matrix and it's gonna come pre-wired. So you don't have to do any wiring there. It's got power and the connection to go to your Arduino already in it. So we're just gonna use some metal L braces and we're gonna put those, screw those to the sides of the light on the inside. And we're going to then just use some hot glue, which I apologize, I forgot to get a shot of that, but we're gonna just use hot glue to attach the LED matrix and suspend it behind about 1/2 inch or 3/4 inch behind the front so that you get some nice diffusion. Then we're just going to take our screw terminal and we're going to hot glue it to the back
inside of the panel. We're going to put our jack in. Now this is an optional step here because I did solder this jack, but I'm going to give you a link to a description to one that you don't have to solder, so you can get by with that without soldering. And that gets to your power supply. So you're going to plug your power supply in. Wires from the power are going to run into these flip connectors, which again require no soldering, to connect it to the LED matrix. The LED matrix is going to run out to one of the JSTs in your Arduino screw terminal. The other JST from your LED push button is going to go into your second JST, and that's it. Pretty happy how this one came out. I hope you like it too. If you did, hit the like button, subscribe so you get notified about future builds and about the contest to win one of these. That's all I've got for this time, so it's a wrap. I'll see you next time.